Hello friends, we will be covering the following. Refraction through curved surface, lens maker formula, power of a lens, refraction of prism. In this experiment, we have placed a curved convex lens. One side is rarer and the other side is denser. So there are two mediums, medium one and medium two. And one is a rarer medium, one is a denser medium. A ray enters from rarer medium to denser medium through convex interface makes real image. The angles are alpha, beta and gamma. So let's look at this picture here. So the object lies, this is the object, O is the object. Object lies in the rarer medium. And this is, it is going to form an image here in this denser medium. So that this convex lens is dividing the two parts, which is medium one and medium two. Medium one is a rarer medium and medium two is a denser medium. The angles formed, a ray which is passing from the object, striking onto the convex spherical surface, and here it bends down and the image is formed here. Why is the image formed here? Because whenever the two rays meet, so this is one ray, okay, and the second ray will be on the axis, like from O all the way to I. So when the ray travels here, the two rays, when they meet, the image will be formed here. So the alpha is the angle here. This is the gamma and this is the beta. The I is the incident angle, which is between the incident ray and the normal. Okay, the reflection, the R is between the normal and this, which is forming, this ray, which is forming the image. Okay, we have drawn a PN, which is this PN we have drawn. Okay, drawn PN to make a triangle PNO. So PNO is a triangle. So in this triangle, N is very close to the pole of the convex lens. So refractive index, what is a refractive index? Refractive index is mu to 1 equals to sin I by sin R. Where is this formula coming from? This is the Snell's law formula, which is equal to mu 2 by mu 1. What is mu 2? Mu 2 is for the denser medium, mu 1 is for the rarer medium. Okay, so we have sin I by sin R equals to mu 2 by mu 1. For small sin A, we normally sometimes take A. So we can, instead of writing all the way sin I, so we are going to write mu 2 by mu 1 equals to I. So we have eliminated sin and we can write I by R. So if we want to derive this formula further, we can write multiplying the numerator with this denominator. So it becomes mu 1 I equals to mu 2 I, cross multiplication. Okay. Here in triangle OPC, where is the triangle OPC? This is a triangle O, P and C. What is the C? C is the center. Center of what? This is the convex spherical mirror. So this is a circle, so spherical. So in this, this is the center. So OPC is an exterior angle. So OPC is an exterior angle. So I, this is the exterior angle. If this is the exterior angle of this triangle, then I will be equal to alpha plus gamma. So we have written down I is equal to alpha plus gamma. Similarly, in triangle PCI, so let's see this triangle PCI. The exterior angle is this gamma, which will be, we can write gamma is equal to R plus beta, or we can say R is equal to gamma minus beta. Now, inserting values in one we get. Okay, now what we have done, instead of writing I, we have derived this formula earlier, mu I equals to mu R. Instead of writing I, we are writing in place of I, we are writing this value. And in place of R, we are writing this value. So we come on to mu 1 into alpha plus gamma is equal to mu 2 alpha minus beta. So when we multiply these together and bring, this becomes mu 1 alpha plus mu 2 beta plus is equal to mu 2 gamma minus mu 1 gamma. So what we have done, we have actually brought the gamma, both the gamma on one side. So it becomes mu 1 alpha plus mu 2 beta equals to gamma, taking it as a common factor outside. So it becomes mu 2 minus mu 1. for small angle, A can be written as sine A or it can also be written as tan A. So here, what we are doing is we are writing mu 1 into tan alpha. So we are substituting the word tan in front of this alpha, in front of this beta, in front of this gamma. So we have mu 1 tan alpha plus mu 2 tan beta equals to tan gamma mu 2 minus mu 1. So what is the value of tan alpha? Tan alpha is Pn by On. Okay. Similarly, tan beta can be written as Pn by Ni. And here tan gamma can be written as Pn by Nc. So we have written these values down. Now, if you notice, this O to N, On, this distance is the where the object is placed. N we are considering very close to the pole. So we are saying O to N can be written as U. Okay, N to C is the radius. N to C is the radius because this is the center point. So it becomes the radius. Radius of what? This is a spherical mirror. A part of spherical has been converted into convex. Okay, so this center all the way to the pole will become R. Ni equals to V. What is V? V is the distance of where the image is kept all the way till here. This is the distance. N to I will be V. So if you see this distance N to I all the way is V. So we have replaced this value here in place of these. So when we put these value, instead of writing On, we have written U. Instead of writing NC, we have written R. And instead of writing NI, we have written V. So we derive this formula. And where does the PN go? PN gets cancelled. So we come to know this as one of the formula that you can note down, which is mu 1 by minus U plus mu 2 by V equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by R. Okay. We are taking a case 2 here. In this object lies in the rear medium and the image form is virtual. Why so? Because we have placed object O close to the pole. If we place close to the pole or even if the convex mirror is not very spherical, it's the curvature is little less, then as well we can say from rarer enters to the denser. So we are taking a ray that enters. So this is the object where it lies. So when it lies here, object lies here, the image formation is happening at this point. So we are studying when the object is very close to the pole. So we know from the Snell's law, mu 1 by mu 2 equals to sin I by sin R. Here angle I is this angle. This is the normal, that's the incident ray. Okay, so this angle becomes I and this angle is the refraction angle. So this angle is R. So we get mu 1 by mu 2 equals to sin I by sin R equals to I by R. Again, we can write mu 1 I equals to mu 2 R. So we are following the same step that we have just done in case 1. So what we are doing in place of writing I, we are going to write in terms of alpha plus gamma. So I is alpha plus gamma, mu 2 is beta plus gamma, and R is the external angle of triangle PIC. This is the PIC, so it's the exterior angle. So let me show you one more time where these values are derived from. So if you have noticed, we have derived the values alpha plus beta. So these values have been derived here. I is equal to alpha plus gamma. And R is equal to gamma minus beta for this particular case. For this case, we have taken value of I is equal to alpha plus gamma, which is the exterior angle. This is the exterior angle. So it will become alpha plus gamma. Okay, for this is the exterior angle R. So it becomes beta plus gamma. The complete angle is being taken. So in this triangle, the exterior angle is R. So we derive these value for I and R. Substituting these value in place of I and R, we get mu 1 alpha plus mu 2 gamma equals to mu 2 beta plus mu 2 gamma. Now taking gamma on one side, bringing all the gammas on one side, so we get gamma, mu 2 minus mu 1 into gamma. And on the left side, we are remaining with mu 1 alpha plus mu 2 beta. Again, we have mentioned that A can be written as sin A. It can also be written as tan A. So in place of alpha, we are going to replace the value of alpha by tan alpha, beta by tan beta, gamma by tan gamma. Now substituting the value for tan, it becomes Pn by On. Okay. And here it becomes Pn by Ni. And here it becomes Pn by Nc. So where is this point P? This is the point P. Okay. From here, it is N here. So these are the values that we have derived. Put values, take value of the sign. So we know this, if you see the object is formed here, when we go on this side, it becomes negative. So object is formed here, so it is minus U. Similarly, the image is also being formed here. So the distance is again minus V. So this is minus U and this is minus V. So this is this spherical curvature distance R. So we have mu 2 minus mu 1 by R. So the value derived is this. So you can note down this formula as well. This is for the case 2. Coming on to case 3. Ray enters from rarer to denser medium through concave interface. So what is the difference between this and this? Here it was convex. Here spherical mirror is actually a concave. So what happens when it enters a concave? So when the line passes from here, this is the object where it is lying. When the ray passes from here, the object is placed here and the image is formed on this side. The curvature, this is the how the spherical is going to be. So the C is the center of the curvature that we are taking. So this is O, this is I, this is C. Actually, this part from here all the way till here will be U. From here all the way till here will be V. And from this point of pole, from here all the way till C will be R. So R is complete from this point to this point. So we know from Snell's law, mu 2 by mu 1 equals to sin I by sin R, which can be written as, not writing sin, we can write straight away I by R. Why? Because if we write A, we can say A equals to sin A, or we can say tan A. So here we can eliminate sin and we can write mu 2 by mu 1 equals to I by R. That becomes the formula mu 1 I is equal to mu 2 R. What is the value of I? Where is I? So here look at this. This is the exterior angle. For which triangle we are taking? We are taking it for this triangle. So what happens? We can write alpha minus gamma equals to I. Okay. Then in place of R, we can say R can be written as beta minus gamma. R being the exterior angle. So we can write R is equal to beta minus gamma. Why? Because beta is equal to R plus gamma, so it can be written as beta minus gamma. Here, if we multiply mu 1 into alpha and minus gamma, we get mu 1 alpha minus mu 1 gamma, and here we get mu 2 beta minus mu 2 gamma. Bringing the gamma on one side, so we can write mu 1 alpha minus mu 2 gamma equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 gamma. Now, instead of writing alpha, just similarly that we have done the two cases, we are going to, instead of writing alpha, we are going to write tan alpha. The moment we write tan alpha here, mu 1 tan alpha, instead of beta, we are going to write tan beta. So instead of gamma, we are going to write tan gamma. The moment we do this and substitute the value of tan, so tan alpha will become Pn by On. And tan beta will become Pn by Ni. And tan gamma will become Pn by Nc. Now here we know the value of On in. On. So O is what? Object. So O to N, we are going to say the distance as U. So this is minus U. Okay, so here it becomes minus u. Here the distance from this point all the way the image is formed is minus v, and the distance from here all the way to the curvature, this point NC, is minus r. Substituting these values, we derive this formula. So you can note down these three formulas that are very important, and sometimes the derivation comes, sometimes you just need to use the formulas in the numericals. Lens maker formula. Here we take two circles. Okay, if you see this diagram carefully, this is one circle and this is another circle. Basically, what is this lens maker formula used for? Their use is in optical shops. How your lens will be calculated is on the basis of this. Okay, so here lens maker formula. Here we take two circles and the center one and center two. So this is the circle. So this will be the center one of this circle. This being the center two of this circle. Its radius respective will be from this point all the way till the center R1. From this point, which is like O2, from this point all the way till the center will be R2. Now we will consider only the overlapping area. So we are going to ignore the one which is faded out, this area. Don't look at this and don't look at this area. We are going to consider only this part as the lens. So the two have gone together. So this is the overlapping lens, which will be denser medium. And rest both are rarer medium. So this area completely is the rarer medium. So is this area the rarer medium that you can see? This is the center part. The center part is the denser medium. O is the object at the principal axis. So where is the object lying? This is the place where the object is lying. So which is the center of the, here you can see this is the object where it is lying. The ray faces two refraction. When the ray travels down, it faces two refraction. Refraction always takes place at the surface. Okay. So the first refraction happens here when it travels from rarer to the denser medium. Then again, the denser to rarer. Now this is already, the ray is in the denser medium. When it has to come out, so again it is going to move from the denser to the rarer medium. So there are going to be two refractions which are going to take place in this lens maker formula, due to which the image is formed at I. So where is the image formed? I, which was initially formed at I2, I dash. So here the image will be formed, the final image. So we know mu2 by V minus mu1 by U equals to mu2 minus mu1 by R. So this we know, at surface S1, ray goes from rarer to denser medium, and we have already derived this formula, which is this. Now putting the values, what is V here? For the first case, the V is O dash to I dash. Okay, from O dash to I dash is our image which should be formed. So this is our O dash to I dash. Here, where is the object kept? It is kept O dash to O. This is the center O dash to O. This is place where the object is kept. So this value is U. And O dash C1. What is O dash C1? O dash C1 is R. The distance, the R, or we can say R1. So R. Similarly, here we have for the second refraction. We know this is the second refraction which is going to happen. We know mu1 by V minus mu2 by U equals to mu1 minus mu2 by R. See, there is a difference between this formula and this formula. Why so? Because one is from rarer to denser and one is again from denser medium to rarer. So these are two refractions happening. So we have two formulas and we are substituting the values. Now in this case, V will be O dash I dash. So where is O dash? This is the place where O dash is and this is I dash. Okay. And So here we have mu1 O dash I. Actually the image, final image is going to be formed here. So we can say O dash I and mu2 is equal to O dash and I dash, because when the object comes from here, initially it was supposed to form an image here. But because of the denser to rarer medium, again, this is where the final image is being formed. So we can say it like this. And R will be O dash C2. This will be R2. Okay, now let's, why O dash R, O dash C2? Because this is the curvature that we are taking now. Okay, so the center for this curvature will be this C2. Now substituting the values, adding equation 1 and 2. We are adding which two equations? We are adding equation 1. This is one equation and we are adding the equation 2. These two equations we are adding. This is for the rarer to denser and this is for the denser to rarer medium. We are adding these two equations. So we get mu O by O dash plus mu O dash I equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by in brackets we can write 1 O dash C1 minus O dash C2. Now substituting the value, what is O O dash? What is O and O dash? This is where the object is kept. This is the place where the object is kept. So it will be minus U because it's in this direction. So it will be minus U. What is this? This is the, like if you take a number line. So whenever we are on this side, we are on this side, it will become minus. So it will be minus U. And O dash I is the place where the final image is formed. Where is the final image formed? Here. This is the place where the final image is being formed. So O dash I will be V. And being in the number line on the right side, so it's going to be positive. So positive V. O dash C. O dash C equals to R1 minus R2. So we are going to write this value R1 minus R2. So substituting these values in terms of V, U and R, we derive this formula. Okay, now we know that what is 1 by F? 1 by F is equal to, if we write 1, V minus 1 by U. That value comes out to be 1 by F. So we substitute that here, we get mu 1. And we get 1 by F equals to mu 2 minus mu 1, 1 by R1 by 1 by R2. And where then we take out, we can rewrite this formula by dividing mu 2 by mu 1 and mu 1 by mu 1. So we can write mu 2 minus 1 by mu 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Now we know mu 2 by mu 1 can also be written as mu. So, instead of writing such a complicated formula mu 2, mu 1, we can replace this by mu. So, we derive at the focal length formula 1 by F is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is the lens maker formula to make lens in eyeglasses shop. Power of lens. Power means power of bending. Okay. These image show how lens bend in concave and convex lens. To calculate power, if we combine lenses, say power formula is equal to, power is equal to 1 by focal length. So SI unit power of a lens will be diopter. When focal length will be 1 meter. Okay, this is the SI unit power of a lens will be 1 diopter when focal length will be 1 meter. So if we combine, if we put two lens together, say this is one lens and this is one lens. So when we put them together, so we can write 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. The figure shows the combination of the lens. How the, when we put the two lens, what the focal length will become. Here, this I mentioned to you, these are just showing you the images show how lens bend in concave and convex lens. Okay, how the rays will eventually bend, where will the focal come out to be. Now we come on to refraction through lens. Okay, now we are going to have six cases in this as well. So we are going to discuss one by one. In case one, the location of the object is infinity. If the object is an infinity, the object, the image is formed at the focal. The image, location of the image is at focal, and the size of the image is a point. Nature of image is real. Orientation of image is inverted. Let's look at this diagram. In this, the object is somewhere outside. It's in infinity. Okay, so this is the ray that is coming. Once the ray strikes here, it's going to bend down. And when it bends here, at the image will be formed at the focal. It will be a size image point. The nature will be real. Orientation of the image will be inverted. Now let's look at the case 2. In case 2, the object is kept between infinity and C. This is the C. It always a lens has 2C. This is C1 and say C2. So between this C and infinity, this image somewhere it is kept. When it is kept here, the image is formed at F and 2F. Between F and 2F, the image is formed. What is 2F? 2F is R. So between focal length and the center curvature, this image is formed. How is this image? The image is smaller in size. Nature is real. It is inverted. So if you see, this is one ray that is coming. When it comes down, it strikes from the focal, comes down here. We take another image which passes from the center of the lens, and here it strikes. So this formation is between F and 2F. This is case 2. In case 3, the object is at C1. Where have we placed the object? We have placed on the center here, 2F. 2F is the distance, the total distance is R. R is the radius, the curvature. Of the curvature, so here we have placed the object. If the its location of the object is at say C1, which is 2F, so location of the image will be formed here, which is at C2. So this is one spherical, okay, this is the second spherical. So when we have kept here, which is the center of C1, so image will be formed at C2. What is the exact size is the same. This is AB and this is A dash B dash. This is the same size. It's real and it's inverted. So this is case 3. Now we have another case where we are going to place the object. Object is placed between the center, that is 2F, and it is placed between the focal. So it's placed here. This is where the image is placed. So location of the object is placed. Where the image will be formed? Image will be formed beyond C. So here, if you can see, this is where the image is formed. The image is going to be larger. It has extended. So it's larger, it's real, and it's inverted. So you can see one is a green ray that is striking from the center of the focal length coming down because it was parallel. When a ray parallel comes down, it passes by the focal. This is where it's going to strike. When the one ray, which is going to by the center, it's going to go here. So this is where the image will be formed and it is inverted. Now, in case 5, the object is at focus. So, where we have kept the object? Object has been placed at the focal. If the object is placed at the focal, image is formed at infinity. See, these two lights are not striking. It's somewhere in the infinity. These two rays are going to meet and the image will be formed at infinity. The size of the image is very large. Size, it is undefined. Nature of the image is undefined because we cannot see it. Orientation of the image is also undefined. We don't know. Now comes in case 6. The object is kept between F and O. When the object is placed here between focal length and the center, say pole here, right here, it's kept very close to the pole. The image is formed on the same size of the object. See the image, which is the image being formed. This is the image that is being formed. Image, it is very large in size. It's very large and magnified. See, this was the object. It has been magnified. The image is virtual. It's not a real image. It's a virtual image. And the image is erect, straight up, the same way. It's not inverted. So this is the image that is formed. Now coming on to refraction of prism. Here, ray PQ will strike at point Q. This is the ray that is coming. P, it strikes at point Q. Instead of going straight, it will bend. Instead of taking this path all the way, it is going to bend here. Okay, because there are two different mediums. So when it bends down over here, it bends in the direction QR. When it bends, it comes here QR. Now when again it will strike at point R, then from the ray will travel, the medium is going to change, the ray will travel to S. It's going to travel in this direction. Instead of going straight up, it's going to bend down here and travel in form of S. This is the angle of deviation. What is angle of deviation? This you can see here. This is angle of deviation. Means the prism ray was supposed to go in this direction, straight up, but it has diverted. What is the path it is taking? It's taking the path PQRS. Why? Because here one refraction is taking place at the surface. This is a different medium. This is a different medium. It bends down. Further, when it strikes here, again, it bends down further. So, in prism, the top angle we are considering as A. This is our angle A. From QR, the normal N1 and N2 meets at the point O. This was the normal. If from this normal we extend it down here, and this from N2 we extend it down here, these two points when they meet, we are terming it as O. So in AQOR, in this AQOR, angle A plus angle O equals to 180 degree. We also know in triangle QRO, in triangle QRO, R1 plus R2 plus angle O will be 180 degree. Okay, this is R1, this is R2, and this is O. So these by the triangle rule, A plus B plus C will be 180 degree. Now comparing 1 and 2, which are the two equations we are going to compare? We are going to compare A plus O equals to 180 degree and R1 plus R2 plus O equals to 180 degree. So once we are going to compare these two equations, we know the exterior angle of deviation can be written as the sum of interior angle in triangle TQR. We are trying to derive the value of this. Okay. In this terms, we know if we have to take out this exterior angle will be the sum of this and the sum of this. Okay. Now here, this angle is I1 minus R1. Why so? Because if this is complete I1, opposite will be also the vertex here. This is going to be I1. But the value we know for this part of the triangle, say it is R1. So this value here, this part, this will become, the value will become I1 minus R1. Similarly, here, this part, as we know, this is I2. So the exterior in the prism, this is I1 we are taking, this is we are taking as I2. So here I2, this complete angle will be I2. And this part we know, this is R2. So it will become this angle, the small angle will become I1 minus I2. So we can say deviation is equal to I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2. This is the value that we have derived. So once we put this I1 plus I2 together, plus R1 plus R2 together by this formula, we have substituted this value. And we also know the value of A is equal to R1 plus R2. Where have we derived this? From these two equations we have derived A is equal to R1 plus R2. Substituting this value, we derived another formula for deviation, which is deviation is equal to I1 plus I2. Instead of writing R1 plus R2, we are going to write minus A. Okay. So we have two formulas that we have written down. One is this formula for deviation, which is I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. And we also have, instead of writing R1 plus R2, we can write minus A. I hope this session was helpful to you. Thank you.